Many companies are allowing their staff to work from home indefinitely, raising questions about how they can protect their company data on personal or uncontrolled devices. So what can we do to protect company data on personal or uncontrolled devices? Well, because we can lose company data in a variety of ways, there's actually a variety of different protection measures that we can put in place. And let's take a look at the features in Microsoft 365 that can help companies protect their data while users are working remotely. Starting with mobile application management. Despite the name, mobile application management doesn't just apply to mobile devices. It can also be applied to Windows 10 devices. And mobile application management policies can protect company data on both company-owned and user-owned devices. And essentially, it works by applying protections to the apps that your teams use to access company data, like Outlook, Teams, OneDrive, and SharePoint. And you can enforce restrictions on these apps to prevent data from being saved, cut, copied, or pasted. You can also require a PIN for your company apps or prevent the app from running on a jailbroken phone or tablet. And the really cool thing about mobile application management is that you can actually selectively wipe your company data from users' personal devices. And prior to this, what some administrators would do would use the Exchange ActiveSync device wipe feature. So when someone would leave the company, they would wipe the person's entire phone. And that made a lot of people very mad. So being able to selectively wipe company data is a really big plus, especially when people are bringing their personal devices in to access company data. Another method to prevent company data from being lost or shared indiscriminately on an unmanaged device is to use conditional access policies. These policies can enforce restrictions on non-compliant or unmanaged devices, such as blocking the device entirely or preventing particular actions like stopping users from saving attachments in Outlook on the web or syncing files to OneDrive. We can apply these protections in other ways in OneDrive and SharePoint too, preventing users from accessing OneDrive and SharePoint via the apps or syncing it down and limiting them to a web-only experience. And these protections don't just apply to Microsoft 365 apps like OneDrive, SharePoint, and Outlook. We can use Microsoft Cloud App Security to apply additional protections to apps like Dropbox Business, for example. Applying a protection to a third-party app like Dropbox Business can prevent users from saving Dropbox files to unmanaged devices too. Having said that, apps like Dropbox Business also have their own security measures in place, allowing you to unlink devices and having certain devices be wiped of company data the next time that they come online. To lessen the likelihood of the wrong people accessing your company data on a shared device, we can configure idle session timeouts. And essentially what these do is just sign you out after a period of inactivity, just like your bank does. Cloud App Security also includes built-in alerts that trigger on potentially suspicious activities. We can use these to get notified about things like mass deletions, mass downloads, or unusual volumes of external sharing. Now, it's not just about ensuring that we're securing and controlling the applications that access our data, but we should also be applying protections to the data itself. We can use data loss prevention to restrict or impose conditions on the sharing of sensitive information. These data loss prevention policies can trigger on certain keywords like project names or sensitive information types like credit card numbers, driver's license details, or tax file information. Once a file containing this information is detected, it can either display a warning, it can be blocked from being shared, or it can have encryption applied. And again, using Cloud App Security, we can also apply additional data loss prevention measures to third-party apps like Box and Dropbox Business. But what happens if all of this fails and someone downloads our sensitive company data to a personal or unmanaged device and we don't have any control over how they share it or who they send it to? To protect against this, we can apply sensitivity labels. And these labels define how sensitive a particular piece of content is and in turn can enforce protections on our data. And what's more, these protections apply no matter where that file ends up. These baked-in protections can limit who can access the file and what they can do with it, preventing the wrong people from saving, copying, forwarding, printing, or sending these documents or emails. And in many cases, these protections can be applied automatically by scanning for those same keywords and sensitive information types that we were looking at in data loss prevention. As you can probably tell by now, there's a lot you can do to protect your company data while people are working from home. And if you need help with any of this, whether you're managing company-owned devices or personal devices or a mix of both, we'd be happy to assist. You can have a chat with us today at gcits.com.